This is the question, and the final question is that we've got the notion that resistance, the more resistance there is, the less current will flow for a given voltage. Yes? Voltage is like pressure. So with more voltage, more current flows, and with less voltage, less current flows, right? Okay? What I can tell you is that when people talk about conductors, there are lots of different conductors, but they're not all made equal. Okay? Copper is really good. It's a pretty good conductor. Okay? Silver would be even better, but I don't have enough money to buy silver. This silvery looking metal is steel, and steel is a pretty good conductor. It's no slouch, but it's not as good as copper. They don't make the transmission lines, well, maybe they do make them out of steel. Okay, but in your house, they're definitely copper, right? And I've got these wires here, and they are all of different lengths, and they are also of different materials. And they are also of different thicknesses. I've got a thick copper wire, an even thicker copper wire, a thick steel wire. Then I've got nichrome wire. This is very long, and this thing is probably 100 feet of it. So it's very, very long. This is a very long wire. It's very narrow. Nichrome is a special alloy that's used to make resistors. It has a lot of resistance. It is specifically designed to have a lot of resistance. Here is copper, and this piece of copper is probably, I bet there's 500 feet of copper on this thing, and it's very thin. So which of these has the most resistance, and which one has the least? If I took a thing that measured resistance from one end to the other, right, which one would have the least resistance? Which would have the most? And could we say for sure without calculating something? And if we calculated something, what sorts of things would we calculate? What sorts of things would we need to know?
The diameter,
there we go. Okay? The diameter of the wire. Diameter specifies the cross-sectional area of the wire. Okay, so if we're talking about a wire like this, it's got a certain amount of area there. And so what do you think? A big wire has more resistance or a big wire has less?
Less.
Big wire has less. A more bigger diameter. This makes it less.
Oh, that makes sense.
Right? This is the same for water pipes, right? A big diameter water pipe has less resistance and can handle more stuff. Yes, does that make sense? So on the street, it's like 3-inch mains, 6-inch mains, 8-inch. Going to your house is probably a 1-inch pipe, right? Going from there inside your house is probably like 3/4 inch, and then down to 1/2 inch is about as small as it goes. Although there are those little tiny tubes that look like they're 1/4 inch that go to like your refrigerator for the ice maker, right? That doesn't draw a lot of current, right? So big is less, right? And then what else? What other factor? The length of it. How do you suppose length affects it? Short is less, yeah. Right? And then is there anything else that we would need to know? The material, there we go. Look at you guys. Okay. So let's just hit the right arrow, okay? It's like, there we go. You don't need to write those down. Those are just on your table on page 535. Okay. But there it is. It's all just the way we thought it would be. That the resistance of a piece of wire, this is wire, talking about a wire, and this is a very short, the picture there is a very short piece of wire, right? But it's very thick, right? It's got some area here. Area for a cylindrical wire like this, the cross-sectional area is pi r squared, if you forgot that, right? And the resistance of this thing, the resistance is the resistivity, right? So the resistivity is something that gets bigger when it offers, relative to other things, more resistance. Hence the term resistivity, right? It's how much the inherent resistance of the material, right? So notice that silver has a very small resistivity. Notice that gold has more resistivity than copper, which is somewhat surprising. So why do they use gold for the connectors for like CPUs and motherboards? Why do they use gold to plate, just the thinnest layer of gold, to plate the connectors for cards that go into the computer? It's not the resistance. Corrosion. Yeah, gold does not corrode. Yeah, gold is like the only one of the few metals that you can find like chunks of gold because it is not very reactive, right? So if you coat conductors with gold, they don't get a layer of oxide. Layers of oxide almost never conduct electricity because their electrons have been bound up with oxygen or something like that. Ask a chemist why, I don't know. Okay? Okay. So aluminium has much more resistivity than copper. Back in the day, in around 1968, copper got expensive, so they started putting aluminium instead of copper in houses. And when they first did it, they used the same size aluminium wires as they did copper, right? And now the problem with that is that the wires heated up, and then eventually they came loose from all their little connectors, because when you heat up, you expand, right? And then they started fires, okay? When they built my house, they went in and they put in 10-gauge wires, which are just super thick aluminum wires, right? And it's still not the best, but at least it's not the ones that we know cause fires, right? You know, I wish I could just go back in time and say, here's $500, put copper in. Spend $500 more dollars. You're going to make a house that'll last 100 years. Yeah? Say it again. Oh, ohms per meter? Where does it say that? Oh, it's ohm meters. The units are ohm meters for resistivity. Yeah? But it's really ohms meters over, I don't know, we'll look at what it is, right? What the meaning of that is. And if you look at the formula, everything is where, shut up, we think it should be. Okay? The length is in the numerator, longer wires have more resistance. The area is in the denominator, bigger wires have less resistance. And then we just have to look up for the material what it is, right? Are we ready for some example? Dimmer, different wires. Okay, so example number one, a steel wire is 2.7 meters long, has a resistance of 7.3 ohms. What is its diameter? What's its diameter? Okay. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to solve for the area. And from the area, I can solve the resistance and the radius. Okay. And then twice the radius will be the diameter. Okay. So I'm using a formula. R is rho L over A. And so 7.3 is equal to, and then we got to look up steel. I guess we use iron. They don't have a separate steel there. So 9.71 times 10 to the minus 8th. So this is ohms. 9.71 times 10 to the minus 8th. And this is ohm meters. Guys, can you be quiet, please? Been fairly tolerant, getting impatient now. 2.7 meters. Yeah, and then divided by area. And if you look at the units here, if you look at the units, ohms is going to cancel, yeah? Right, and then this is square meters. Square meters is going to cancel square meters. If we solve that for the area, that's going to be 9.71 e minus 8 times 2.7 divided by 7.3, right? Is that right? You put the area up here, put that guy down there. And you get that the area is really, really small. Remember, a square meter is like giant, right? The wires that hold up the Golden Gate Bridge probably have a cross-sectional area of a square meter. This is 3.5914 times 10 to the minus 8th square meters is the area. Did anybody else get that? But that's not the question. It's not what is the cross-sectional area in square meters. It was what is the diameter, right? So I'm going to say pi r squared equals that number, right? And this is square meters. And so that